NerdDice.
Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 50 in our series, Create a RubyGem, NerdDice. So we, in our last episode, we worked on the documentation, made a couple tweaks on our functionality, which is just as I was writing the information in the README, it made me reconsider a couple of small implementation points. So we made those changes. Our pull request to master is open. And before I merge it, so I went back to the backlog and specifically broke out add the die and die set functionality to the benchmark suite and then the ability score. So we'll go in and do this. Just to set expectations, I expect this to be significantly slower than just the total dice method because it's going through and instantiating objects, setting properties and all that. So that should be our expectation, is that it's much slower relative to the baseline benchmarks. But we want to have these in place so in the event that we go and change something and it royally breaks what was in place, we have something to compare it to. So we'll go to our NerdDice benchmark here. So we've already got the check against benchmark here. All of these, we're going to see how many times we've got this happening. So we're going to take all of these and we're going to replace nerd dice with total dice here. With a trailing underscore. And then we will go through and first, let's save it, make sure I didn't break anything. So let's go back to that one that I failed on. 5.0. Just go ahead and make it 30. And then we'll have a section here for each of these with roll dice. I will open up a new window. Control H it. Make sure I didn't break anything yet. Nope, still still good. And then we now need to do these four. Go back to our untitled item here. So these should all fail, but at least give. It actually did better than I would have thought there. Make sure that I'm actually calling it. So that looks to be correct. I'll do the same thing with the 3d6, and then we'll go and tweak our numbers in the hash. So, to make that roll dice secure random, random rand. Oh, where did we roll dice randomized? All right, so it made it farther. And what was our eight. Again, that's not too bad. Dice randomized. Increase that. Let's see if we can get through this. That was random ran 36. That was 62, so I'll make that 65, make this 70. Those. All right, so we passed that time. Let's take a look at our ratios and how they compare to total dice. So we're looking at, for most of these, about a factor of 2, which isn't that bad considering that you're going through and you're instantiating objects for each die being rolled and instantiating the dice set collection on it. So it's not that bad. If we look at our issue here with random rand and normal rand. So normal rand runs already at a more than twice as slow as kernel random and random.rand. So you think about, we're talking, since it's going up the hierarchy to find that, going up the call stack, and when you multiply that times however many thousands or millions of times, that adds up and winds up taking much longer to do. But overall, this is running relatively fast, even when you've got multiple dice being instantiated per roll. So I think we can be fairly satisfied with this. I'm going to run it. I'll pause and run it about 15 or 20 times on our locally to make sure that it that's fairly stable before trying to push it and use the GitHub action. So I've run this a bunch of times and it has succeeded each time so far. So I'm going to try committing our changes and seeing how it fares with the GitHub action. So I've got my commit message, got it signed. We'll try pushing this. I anticipate that this will potentially fail when we get to the GitHub actions like our other local attempt at this did. So we'll do that and see what happens. Here, we'll wait for them to finish. So both of them failed. Let's see whether they failed in the same place or not. So this one failed on 3 versus 3.82 on roll dice secure random. And the other one also failed on roll dice secure random. So it looks like we need to be a bit more liberal in those ratios. We'll try modifying that. So we'll come back here. So this was 3.0, make it 4.0, make that 10.0. And I'm going to add probably a few percentage points for each of these. Try that. I'm gonna do a git commit amend on it and force push it. Do that. Again, force push to the branch, make sure the log reflects what I wanted it to. It does. Let's go back to our overall set of actions, let them complete. Failed again. Take a look at the benchmark. Failures now. Roll dice randomized. Roll dice randomized. try that again. I'll just, you get the idea of what I'm going to do. I'm just going to pause it and keep going until I get a success here. So these went green the next time I did them. So all I really had to do is change this randomized item up to 11.5, and it seemed to work. We will try to now merge this. Master. So we'll make sure our status is clean. Forward merge and push. See how so it closes the pull request. That shows as merged. Our issue. That issue. Go to our project. Move the issue to done. Move that to done. We'll look at our actions. The push and merge into master succeeded. So now our code on master should have our new commits. It does. Let's check our coverage. Looks good. Build, as noted before, was passing. And then maintainability still at an A. So we will call this an episode, and we'll come back next episode with the retro, and then we'll start on that ability scores, which will be a small, much smaller epic, and then we should be close to releasing 0.3 for this gem. Thanks for watching this stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding. And don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.